Shockwaves from Japan's Fukushima nuclear plant disaster have reverberated loudly in Germany. So much so that despite the fact that atomic energy provides nearly a quarter of the nation's electricity, it's still ready to pull the plug. RT's Laura Emmett found out what price both Germany and other EU countries might have to pay for such a bold move.
Germany raises a lone voice in the EU to usher in a new era of non-nuclear power generation as Chancellor Angela Merkel vows to close all its reactors by 2022. But it's already created a shortfall in electricity in Germany, which in turn is pushing up prices. Germany's now importing power from France and the Czech Republic, and it's the crisis hit poorest who will pay.
The higher electricity cost will quite understandably, you know, project into the prices. And of course, who is buying the industrial goods, you know, who will be paying more for the electricity will be the consumer, will be the people. There is no doubt about it.
Around 30% of the EU's electricity comes from nuclear generation. So ironically, the electricity Germany ends up buying will be generated at nuclear power plants. The majority of European countries aren't giving up their nuclear programs. Switzerland is phasing it out, but France, which has a long and successful history of nuclear power generation, sees it as a solution for the future. Britain, Sweden, Spain and Belgium are just some of the other EU countries that have nuclear capacity and aren't planning to get rid of it. So closing down its own reactors won't stop Germany suffering from nuclear fallout in the event of an accident elsewhere in Europe. But the German Green Party is aiming high.
We're planning that whole Europe is going to be nuclear free. At the moment, 13 of 27 nations in the European Union don't have any nuclear plants, so it's a lot, and we want to make them get off at the time maybe 2030, and then everything's free.
But are they aiming at the wrong goal? The EU wants to generate 20% of its electricity using renewables by 2020 and also to reduce carbon emissions. Nuclear power was a good way of bringing emissions down, but Germany will need to go back to its coal-fired power stations to make up the shortfall.
In terms of climate policy, Germany has, with the EU, is trying to reduce CO2 levels. And if you switch off nuclear energy as an option, then you have to turn to coal, and which is a lot more polluting in that respect.
Experts say the biggest price to pay in switching off nuclear power is the uncertainty of what will replace it in the short and long terms. How will it affect the gas price? What if biofuels grow in popularity, prompting poor communities to grow fuel crops rather than food? These are unknowns, although one expert said it could cost €3 trillion for the whole of Europe to start using green technologies.
Here in the heart of the EU, there's consternation that such a big decision should be taken unilaterally by Germany, seemingly as a panicked reaction to the Fukushima disaster. But the fact is, Europeans are all in this together. If there's a nuclear accident, for example, in France, Germans won't be immune just because they're not involved in nuclear power anymore. And a German shortfall in supply will mean higher electricity bills for all European families, not just Germans. Laura Emmett, RT, Brussels.